Most of farmer in Thailand, they have a dream. They want to be like American farmer. Whenever they watch the movie, they see American farmer work in the field with the big tractor. They have the big machine to work in the farm. They have airplane to spray. They have a big land. They have a nice silo. Many people dream that they want to be like that because they believe that when we have high technology in farming, we will work less. We work less and we will be more relaxed. We will be more happy when we have more money. That's the dream of most farmers in Thailand. In the last 2 years, I have a chance to visit many farmers in America. I talk with many of them because I have some question in my mind that are they really happy? How hard is it to be developed farmer like that? After talking with many of them, I heard the same thing from most of them. It's not beautiful like that. Their life is not beautiful like that. High technology, it means high cost, high money to put it on. So one big tractor is a lot of money. One silo is a lot of money. It's more than the income that they can make it per year sometime.
For the fertilizer and your taxes and the water, that thing just costs so much now.
Yeah.
And so that's why some of these guys farm so much stuff.
Yeah, you have to.
You got to farm 20,000 acres to make what you used to make on 200 acres. And then, I mean, is it worth it?
Then you have to invest and invest and invest.
Right.
It makes me think about farmer in Thailand. It's quite similar. Before that, our farmer, we don't have machine. We use a buffalo to plow the land. No farmer worry about debt. No debt, nothing. They use the buffalo to plow and then they feed the buffalo. Buffalo poop and then they get cow dung, buffalo dung to put in the farm. And then they can sell buffalo in a higher price. Buffalo is like saving for them. The price of buffalo never go down. Let's make their life quite smooth. But later on, not really long, when the small tractor came, one small tractor that they walk after the tractor, that one, it cost maybe $1,000. $1,000 is very convenient, but that's the whole income per year for one family. So they sell the rice 1 year, they got $1,000. So if they use the whole money to buy a tractor, they don't have any money to do anything else. And after that, they need to borrow money to invest in farming. So they start to have debt because when they start to have machine. And not many years later, there's a big tractor came. When the big tractor came, they pay maybe $10,000. But they have to be in debt for many, many years. But farmer is very risky career because some year is drought, some year is flood. It depends on the climate a lot. And then it depends on the market too. Whenever they have a high yield in farming, the price in the market going down. whenever they have drought, the price in the market rising up, but they don't have anything to sell. So when decide to buy the machine, it's like they get into the trap. They cannot get out of it. That's the situation in Thailand. But in America, it's quite similar, actually. Very similar. But their debt is bigger and bigger. A lot bigger. Because in America, one farmer, they have 5,000 acres or 10,000 acres of their land. And when they buy one truck, it's a big truck. It costs so much money. So, big farmer, more technology, they have bigger debt than small farmer. Many farmers told me that. Actually, their life is very fragile because the farming there, they have to invest a lot of money on seeds. The price of seeds is very high because 90% of American farmers use GMO seeds. And then they develop the seed to fit with different area. This area they have flood, they decide seed for flood. This area they have drought, they decide seed for drought, for to make it fit with the situation. And then high technology seeds cost so much money. And then it's not only seed, you need to buy chemical, you need to buy fertilizer, you need to buy so many things with the seeds. So when they invest money a lot on seed and chemical, when they grow, they need to rely on the weather. The weather is changing rapidly now because of climate change. It's not like in the past. Many areas, they never have drought, they have drought. Some areas, they never have flood, they have flood, big flooding. So that's make farmer bankrupt very fast. The debt pile up every year. Farmer in America, they said, the cost of their farming is higher than in Thailand 5 times, at least. They grow corn, they grow soybean. Corn and soybean is the main crops there, and wheat. The cost of 1 kilo of corn, they have to pay higher than 1 kilo of corn in Thailand 5 times to grow them. But they need to ship it from America to sell in Thailand in many countries to sell it cheaper than us. How can they do that? That's because of the government subsidize it. So farmer in America, in developed country, they use high technologies, very expensive. They use high technology seeds, it's more expensive. And they need to use more petroleum, more diesel. Some farm, they use a lot of diesel every year. So their farming depends on diesel completely. If there's no petroleum, if we have crisis on energy, all farmers in America paralyzed immediately. So they have a high yield because of they use a lot of petroleum. And then they survive because of subsidized from government. Every developed country in the world, farmers cannot survive by themselves. It look nice, look fancy, look comfortable to be a farmer, but in practical, they suffer quite a lot. They cannot survive by themselves. even in Europe. I met one guy from Europe. He said he has 500 cows in his farm. He do cow milk. But he work only two people. Take care of 500 cows. They use all, everything in the farm is computer. They use computer control everything. They just press button. People don't need to touch thing much in there. He said, we got very high yield. We're very successful in farming to produce a lot of milk. But in economical way, they cannot survive. Because the cost is so high, they cannot survive without subsidies from government. So this is what happened in developing country where they use a lot of high technology of machine, of everything in farming. What happened is so many farmers have depression. They have a lot of stress because of debt pile up every year. They suffer from worry a lot. And in the same time, the last 2 years, I think the Center for Disease Control and Prevention have some report that American farmer commit suicide more than every career in America 5 times. And then every year, many American farmer bankrupt a lot every year, especially in Trump's era. Many milk farm bankrupt. Some farmer told me that more than 15% of milk farm bankrupt in 3 months during Trump policy about immigrant. So when immigrant move out, they have no worker. So high technology in farming is a question. Do we need that? Because everywhere when they use high technology, you can see farmers have a big pile of debt. They have more debt than people in the country that they use less technology. I think high technology always expensive, because technology, when you produce it, you make a lot of money from it. You sell so expensive, but when farmer produce some products from their farm, the price always going down. Every products in the world, you can make your own price. If you make one table, you can calculate how much money you invest in that table. It may cost $10, the whole thing, for the material, for the labor, for electricity, for everything is about $10 to get one table. So you can add 10%, 15%, 30% or 50% of profit in there, and then you can sell that price. That's normal business. But farming, it does matter how much you put money in your farming, in your corn or wheat or rice or cassava, but you need to sell this price. So this is one thing that tells us that farming, we should not invest too much money on it. Farming should not be business, because you cannot make your own price. So from my experience, I think farmer need to think different from normal. We cannot think the same way anymore. We cannot think in the way that we need high technology in everything anymore. We need to think about appropriate technology. if farmer come back and start to invent some simple thing, like a one boy in my village, he used old machine from the motorcycle, adapted into a small tractor. He used the old motorcycle that people throw away already. He bought it from the junk, and then he fix it and add plow, add everything in there, add the wheel in there, and he can plow the land. If farmer come back to develop their own tools, their own machine, in the way that they can control it by themselves, they can make it by themselves, and don't rely on fertilizer, don't rely on commercial seed so much. Develop our own seed, propagate our own seeds, make our own compost, design our new land, design our farm in different way from the way we used to do. No cash crop. I think we will survive. Farming need new technique, new way, new thinking, because the old way of farming cannot survive anymore.